Hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know, a long time no see, but life kinda hit me hard, but now I'm back and I'm feeling good. And today I thought it's finally time to do a tattoo tour of my upper body. So I'm gonna split it into two. So I'm gonna do upper body today and then lower body in the next video. So I'm just gonna do it from top to bottom. So this one, oh my God. So I wanted to have like a sphinx cat in that work, and I went to an artist that was really new into tattooing, so he was a trainee pretty much, and the tattoo was horrible and I had to walk around like that for a year. Then I got it covered up. I mean, it's better now, but it's not perfect. It's a cat with a bow and roses, and I still want to get something on top here because it's pretty empty on the shoulder. So the next one is Bulbasaur.
Bulbasaur,
I got that one done by my ex-boyfriend who is specialized in anime tattoos. It's also in duck work, and I really, really like this one. It also healed really, really nicely. So I'm gonna link his Instagram right here. He's based in Vienna and really good if you want something colorful anime tattoo related as well. And then on the inside, I have a cute squirrel tattoo with a nut. All my tattoos pretty much are just black ink because I just like that on myself. I love color tattoos on others, but on myself I really prefer black ink, so that's why it looks like that. Then here there's just positive life, and I have this on the other side as well, so it's positive mind, positive life. And then here on the elbow ditch, I have a mandala with a heart. That one kind of hurt. For me, like arms, I would say upper arm was like a 3 out of 10. Then here, this ditch, I would give like a 8 out of 10, because that one, especially the heart here, that one hurt really bad. Next, we have this rose. This was actually my second tattoo, the rose, and I wanted it to face me, but the artist said it would be better if it would face just like outside, like normal. But yeah, I wanted it to look my way. I hate it, but it's here, I guess. It's also not really well done, the dot work, like the dots are really, really big, but yeah, it's here, it's okay. That one is also done by an apprentice, that's why it's not perfect, but it's alright. Then I got a sleeping fox with a heart on its forehead. I really like that one. Then that one, yeah, that is my least favorite tattoo. I hate it. I got it done at a tattoo convention in Austria. So the artist actually drew it kind of good. So I was like, okay, let's get it. But he used like really thick needles, and it's really thick, and it kind of reminds me of a bug, and I hate it. But yeah, I think I have to cover it someday. But right now it's here, it's on the backside, so I don't see it a lot, so it's all right. Then I have the vegetarian symbol. I actually got that one because I don't like the vegan symbol with the sunflower, so I just got the vegetarian symbol. Then this one actually is another writing. It just says be yourself. It's really hard to show, but I just saw it on the internet and got it pretty much, yeah. And then I have the Pisces symbol right here because I'm a Pisces, born in March, and like I'm the Pisces that you can be, like everything. If you Google Pisces, and there's like creative, dreamy, everything that's written on the internet, that's me. I'm 100% Pisces, so I got that one as well. And on the fingers, I just have the small heart right here. And I also have 3 dots on each finger right here. And then I also have the insides of the finger, but it hurts so bad. Like that one, that was a 10 out of 10. It hurts so bad. And the ink didn't stay inside really well. So I think you can see be brave. Like that one is be brave. And that one is stay strong, but you kind of cannot read the Y and the G anymore because it's like the ink is faded so much. I have to get them redone, but I don't know when, because I really hate the side of the finger. Like it hurt really bad. Also for the lower arm, pain wise, I would give it like a 4 out of 10. And maybe the inside right here, it was a bit more painful, maybe like a 7 or 8 out of 10. So that was the left arm. Now let's go on to the right one. So let's start on top as well. So I have an elephant right here. I just saw that design on the internet and really liked it. I have a ton of animals on me because I love animals so much. So I got that one done. Then next, I have this cute shell design. I really liked how simple the design was, and I also think that it fits this area quite nicely, so that's why I got that one done. Then next to the shell, there's a teacup because I drink so much tea. I thought it's very fitting if I get a teacup, and that one is also okay. Like, there's better designs, but I don't mind it. It's okay. Then on the back side here, I got like a design with stars, the moon and mountains because it reminds me of my hometown. And it's also a pretty easy design. It's not perfect, but I like it. Then we have a sleeping raccoon. So on this side I have a sleeping fox, and here is the sleeping raccoon. That one was done by my ex-boyfriend when he started tattooing, and yeah, it's pretty nice. I like it. So next I have this Korean writing right here. It says forever we are young. I got that one done after I was at the BTS concert in 2019 with my best friend at Wembley, and it was just a really magical moment, and I was so happy that I could share it with my best friend. So that's why it's our friendship tattoo, and we both got it. And that's also one of my most meaningful tattoos because it always reminds me of the concert, and it was one of the best days ever. So yeah, I love that one a lot. Then over here I have a flamingo, and that one is a sister tattoo. So my sister has the same one, and I just got that one because my sister has really long legs and it reminded me of a flamingo. So it's our sister tattoo. Over here I have compassion because I've been vegan for 9 years now and I love animals and I want to have compassion for all living beings. So that's why I got that one. Then underneath it we have a cute bunny. I got that one done in New York actually at a studio. It was called Bristle Tattoo. I love it so much. It's a cute bunny in a cup. So right next to the bunny there's a cute giraffe. I love that one. It's a really cute design, and the giraffe looks really happy. That's why I got it. And then on the back side I got a lighthouse in a heart shape with stars. I got that one just because I like the design. There's no meaning behind it or anything else. And also here on the right side for the upper arm, I would give it like a 3 to 4 out of 10. Here on the inside, the skin is a bit thinner, so it hurts a bit more, but it's bearable. So it's really not that bad. And here the ditch is still empty, so I still have to get that one. I'm not looking forward to that. And then lower arm, it's all right. I would give it also like a 4 out of 10 maybe. Then here I have vegan because I've been vegan for 9 years. Veganism means a lot to me and I don't plan to ever go back to eating meat, so that's why I got it. Last on this arm is also a mandala piece. It's also really fine lines with dot work, and I really like that one. So this one was actually done by the same artist that also did that one. So then on the right hand I have a bow and a moon and also the three dots as well. Oh, and I forgot to tell you, hands like fingers, like I told you on the side of the fingers, it was like a 10 out of 10, I hated it. The dots were okay, I think they were like a 6 or 7 out of 10. And the other ones on the fingers, I guess fingers, because like the skin is really thin and there's not much fat, it kind of hurt, so I would give it like a 7 or 8 as well. So I guess that's everything on the right arm. Let's see. Oh, I forgot that one. I also have a cute lipstick here with some dots and glitters and also some planets inside. I really like that one. So that was everything on the arms. So let's go to the chest. The chest is actually the last tattoo that I've done, and I also have a YouTube video on the chest tattoo, on the whole experience, so I'm gonna link it also in the description below so you can check it out. It looks like that. I have gemstones in the middle and then some flowers and some leaves as well. That one, paint-wise, was an experience. In the middle, like here, I would give it like a 9 out of 10. And the other parts like an 8 out of 10. It was an experience, I wouldn't do it again, but I have it and I'm really, really happy because I really like it. The last one, actually in the front, is the tattoo that I have here. I'm gonna try to show it to you. So this one is a moon with a Unalomi design. I really, really like this one. That's why I got it. There's no deep meaning behind it. I love moons. I'm a moon child and yeah, that's why I got it. It was painful, I remember that, but it was also done really, really quickly. I would say it was like a 7 to 8 out of 10, but it was really quick, so it wasn't that bad. So that's all the tattoos that I have in the front, and then on the back I just have one tattoo. It's really hard to show you, so I'm gonna ask a friend to film it for me, so I'm gonna insert the video right here. So the tattoo in the back is a seed of life. I really like that symbol. And that is actually the only tattoo that I have that has color inside. It has some watercolors, splatters. I didn't expect the back to hurt that bad. And I was like, oh my God, I still have to get my whole back tattooed. And if everything hurts that bad, then oh my God, how am I gonna do this? But yeah, it's still the only one that I have on my back. So I really have to get some more. Pain-wise, I would say that one was like a 7 to 8 out of 10. It wasn't that nice to get, but I really like it. So that were all the tattoos on my upper body until now. So I'm gonna do the part 2 in the next video where I'm gonna show you all the tattoos on my lower body because I also have a lot on my legs. So you can look forward to that. So if you have any questions about the tattoos, pain, process, anything else, just let me know down in the comments and I'm gonna answer them. So thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel as well. Stay happy and healthy and see you in the next one. Bye bye!